Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I want to discuss with you what could happen if you don't manage your diabetes. After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you'll find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 or 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. Now, I want to begin this video by stating I'm not trying to scare anyone. I'm not being some type of alarmist. I am simply going to give you the facts of what can happen to you if you don't manage your diabetes well. I am not saying it's your fault, nor am I passing judgment on anyone. I just want you to know the consequences that could take place if your diabetes goes unchecked. Now, I've had the opportunity to work with some really amazing people in my life. I developed a very good relationship with the folks at Prevention Magazine over the years, and one of their contributors is Cindy Kuzma. I want to thank her for helping me gather research for this video. I would also like to thank Robert Gabby, the Chief Medical Officer at Joslin Diabetes Center in Boston. The work at Joslin is amazing, and I highly recommend you visit their website for some really great articles and information. Okay, with all that said, let's look at what can happen if your diabetes is not under control. You are prone to a heart attack. Let's do a quick review of what the body does with both type 1 and type 2 diabetes. In type 1, your body stops producing insulin, a hormone that regulates blood sugar. With type 2, your body can't properly use the insulin you do produce. Now, this causes your body to have a drop in HDL, which is the good cholesterol. Now, this can also cause the harmful blood fats, which are called triglycerides, to build up. Insulin resistance can also lead to the arteries becoming narrowed and hardened. Now, this can lead to high blood pressure and other heart-related problems. As a result, about 70% of people with either type of diabetes also have hypertension, a risk factor for stroke, heart disease, and trouble with thinking and memory. Failing to control high blood pressure and high cholesterol, either with diet and exercise alone or by adding medications, accelerates the rate at which all your other complications progress, and that's according to Dr. Robert Gabby. In addition to raising your blood pressure and cholesterol, high blood glucose can directly damage your veins, arteries, and heart muscle. Anyone with diabetes has nearly double the risk of a heart attack, and their risk of stroke quadruples. Heart attack is the number one killer in diabetics, says Gabby, and aside from frequency after being fatal, strokes could cause paralysis and other severe diabetes. Keeping along those lines, you do have a higher chance of brain damage. Your brain is a finely tuned organ, but it's sensitive to the amount of sugar or glucose it receives as fuel. Whether you have type 1 or type 2, both the high blood glucose of uncontrolled diabetes and the low blood glucose that sometimes comes with diabetes treatment can affect your brain. Some of the diabetes effects on the brain aren't obvious right away, especially when they are related with high blood sugar. With diabetes, you have an increased risk of damage to blood vessels over time, including damage to the small vessels in the brain. This damage affects the brain's white matter. Now, that's according to Dr. Joseph Mazdu, a PhD and MD of the Houston Methodist Neurological Institute. White matter is the part of the brain where nerves talk to one another. When the nerves in the brain are damaged, you can have changes in thinking called vascular cognitive impairment or vascular dementia. Vascular cognitive impairment can happen with either type 1 or type 2, but there are some differences in risk. The longer you have diabetes in general, the more of a chance there is of developing dementia. But we see much less of it in people with type 1 whose diabetes is well controlled. Now, that's according to Dr. Joel Zolzin, director of the Clinical Diabetes Center at Montefiore Medical Center in New York. People with type 2 may face a double whammy because they tend to have other problems that also can cause blood vessel damage. These patients tend to be less metabolically fit overall, with low HDL cholesterol, high triglycerides, and high blood pressure, and they're more likely to be obese, says Zalzine. Diabetes can combine with these other problems to create inflammation that damages blood vessels, so good diabetes control is all the more important, especially for the brain. You may also see a fade in vision. More than 4 million people with diabetes have some degree of retinopathy, or damage to the light-sensitive tissue at the back of the eye. Now, this happens because high blood glucose levels harm the eye's delicate blood vessels, a process that can actually begin 7 years before you're diagnosed. The early stages have no symptoms, but the longer you let things go, the darker the picture becomes. One study that looked at people with type 2 found that when A1C levels rose by 1 percentage point, the risk of eye problems developing or worsening increased by about 1/3. In 20 years, about 80% of people with diabetes have retinopathy, and about 10,000 go blind each year. You will experience kidney problems. Over time, high blood glucose thickens and scars the nephrons, the tiny structures within the kidneys that filter your blood. About 7% of the time, you'll already have protein leaking into your urine, an early sign of kidney problems. By the time you receive a type 2 diabetes diagnosis, about half of those who don't take steps to control their diabetes will sustain kidney damage within 10 years, and 40% of those will progress to kidney failure, a condition requiring either dialysis or a kidney transplant. Your nerves can break down. About 7.5% of people already have neuropathy or nerve damage caused by high blood glucose when they're diagnosed with diabetes. Eventually, about half of the people with type 1 or type 2 will develop it. At first, you might have no symptoms or feel a mild tingling or numbness in your hands and feet. But eventually, neuropathy can cause pain, weakness, and digestive troubles as it strikes the nerves that control your gastrointestinal tract. You're also going to have foot problems. As damage to the long nerves between your brain and lower limbs worsens, your muscle tone slackens and the shape of your foot changes, causing bunions, flat feet, and other deformities. One wrong step or pebble in your shoe can cause a small ulcer. Numbness means you may not notice it, and poor circulation from damaged blood vessels slows healing. The end result, a rampant infection that spreads to the bone. People with diabetes undergo about 73,000 lower limb amputations per year, and about 60% of amputations overall are in people with diabetes. Now, all of these health problems can eventually add up to the ultimate complication, an earlier death. A recent study in the Journal of American Medicine suggests women with type 1 diabetes can expect to live 13 fewer years than people without the disease. Diabetes officially ranks as the 7th leading cause of death, but since death certificates sometimes list complications rather than the disease itself, that actual number may be much higher. I know this has been a dim video today, but one that I hope you take very seriously. Don't forget to get my new ebook, like this video, and subscribe to our channel so we can continue to bring informative videos to you like this one in the future. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.